Hello, my name is Martyn Park. I'm the writer-director of this movie, iSOLATE, that you have kindly taken your time out to watch. iSOLATE is the fourth feature I made as a Lonedog Production, which is the production entity that I use when I work as a one-man crew. And it was the second film that I had worked with Jacinta John, acting in a lead role, the first being a film I made back in the 90s called Kelly's Thesis. Jacinta won a couple of Best Actress awards for her performance in iSOLATE, one in LA and one in Sydney, which was well deserved, as she is a brilliant actress and an outstanding director in her own right, which is what she focuses on primarily these days, mostly theatre, musical theatre. Terry Serio is the male lead. I'd worked with Terry on 1MC Something of Vengeance, and it was good to work with him again on this, as he's a real pro and can pretty much play any role, which makes it very easy as a director, and he's great in this. I shot it on the Panasonic HVX200, but this time without the Red Rock Micro M2 lens adapter, as I'd used on the previous two films, 1MC Something of Vengeance and One and Only, as I knew that I needed to move the camera around extensively, so I basically had a similar but more advanced rig to the one I used on my first Lonedog production film, Instant Karma, which allowed me to operate both the camera and the microphone at once. For the location, I looked everywhere and finally settled on a property outside of Lithgow, which is just on the other side of the Blue Mountains in New South Wales, Australia. It was a 400-acre property with barns and a great house and mini horses and lots of character, and other than one scene shot in a cafe, everything else was shot on this property. It took me 2 weeks to shoot it, and it was hard work. I'd got used to standing and staring at a monitor, and now here I was running around all over the place lugging a bunch of gear strapped to my body, but the result was worth the effort. I'm very proud of this film. If after watching you have any questions or comments, then leave them in the section below. I will be putting up some more of my older films on this channel soon, so perhaps you could subscribe to be notified if you wish. And of course, nice reviews are always good to get, so if you enjoy, then please leave one on IMDb or wherever you wish. I'm also considering making a behind-the-scenes commentary track, mostly directed toward other filmmakers and enthusiasts if anyone is interested, particularly if YouTube gets the multiple audio tracks feature working for everyone soon. Also, my latest feature film, Spencer, which unfortunately lost most of its festival screenings due to all the COVID lockdowns, will be on my Gumroad channel for some time for some preview screenings if anyone wishes to take a look. You can just email me and I'll send you a code so you can watch it for free, or you can just pay the few dollars to stream it. I'll leave a link in this video description. Anyway, I could ramble on all day, but I won't. I thank you again for taking your time out to watch this, so let's get on with the show.
You up? Dad? I'm coming in. Where are you? Where are you? Breakfast ready? Thank you.
Nice to see how many turned up. Pretty well most of the locals. Just goes to show how well liked your mum was around here. I reckon when it's my turn, the only way anybody would front up at the funeral is if I was put on free beer.
That's not true.
Yeah. Maybe. There's always something going on. Something. Trying to whip ya. Especially out here. Still. Better here than there, I reckon.
See, left.
Just now.
Nice of him to stick around. Not a bad guy for a cop.
Not a bad guy, period, Dad.
We have to talk.
What about?
Things that aren't so nice to talk about.
Not now, Dad. Let's just get through today, all right? We've got plenty of time to talk about what it means.
Sweetheart, you've got plenty of time. I don't. Well, your mum and I had a plan. We discussed it at length.
No, not all about your plan, Dad. Mum told me about it. She called me. She told me the night you worked it all out. Head off around the world, quick trip. Plenty of stamps in the passport, holding hands all nice and lovey-dovey. I'll pick up a few supplies on the way home. Jump into bed. Couple of quick jabs. Quick peck on the cheek. End of story. Dad's illness fixed. Mum left on her own. All nice and neat and dad-like.
I know how it made her feel, Scout. We talked about it.
She told you what you wanted to hear. She told me how it made her feel. I'm not suggesting I have even the remotest idea of what you're having to live through, Dad. But if you think I'm gonna pick up where Mum left off, then you're totally crazy. You're totally crazy. Do you understand? No matter what it takes, I'm gonna help you. I'm gonna look after you. I'm gonna stay here and I'm gonna help you until you die of natural causes.
Natural causes. Sweetheart, it starts in your knees and it goes through your body till you're just a spongy vegetable. You can't even wipe your own ass. I don't want it. What, and in the meantime, what do? I just wait and relive your mum drowning and I watch you. I watch you running this place. You should be out living your own life, sweetheart. Living your life. You know, I just... Help me.
Dad, you in there?
Joel, hi, it's Scout out of the Taylor Station. I'm calling because I think my dad might have come in to see you guys to see if you could take a look at my car. It's been playing up a bit lately and, well, he said it might be the battery or the alternator, but anyway, the car's gone and so's dad, so if he's there, you probably know all this already. Also, there's just, If you can call me back, that'd be really good. I'd appreciate it. Okay, thanks. Bye.
It says here, Dad, Dad, it says here, an enthusiast displays an intense and eager interest in something. A fanatic is not only intense and eager, but possibly irrational in his or her enthusiasm, suggesting extreme devotion and a willingness to go to any length to maintain or carry out his or her beliefs. A zealot exhibits not only extreme devotion, but vehement activity in support of a cause or goal. But it's the bigot who causes the most trouble, exhibiting obstinate and often blind devotion to his or her beliefs and opinions. In contrast to enthusiast, fanatic, and zealot, the term bigot implies intolerance and contempt for those who do not agree.
Which one of those best describes me?
None of them.
None of them?
No.
Well, what am I then?
Lovely. Adjective. Exquisitely beautiful. You have lovely eyes. Lovely views. Informal. Very pleasant or enjoyable.
Delightful. We've had a lovely day. She's a lovely person. I'm getting cold, sweetheart.
I'll go get your chair. Scout Taylor here, do you read? This is Scout Taylor on the Robinson's track, do you read? This is Scout Taylor, I have an emergency situation on the Robinson's track, do you read?
There you go. Best way to start the day.
I didn't order anything.
No, I know. It's on the house.
How much pregnant are you?
27 weeks.
You have other kids?
No, I don't have any children at all. I'm having this baby for some friends of mine. They can't have any children of their own.
Do you mind sitting down and talking to me for a minute?
Yeah, sure. You've been drinking a bit. can ramble if you like. I'm a pretty good listener.
Have you ever seen me in this shop before?
Yeah. You're in here every day. 2, maybe 2:30. You order a large, long black, take away 2 sugars. But today, for some reason, you've come in before I've even kind of really opened, and you've decided to sit down.
Touché. This is spot on. You know, I've never really noticed you before today. Because if it's got nothing directly beneficial to do with me, then it's like it doesn't exist. You know, my whole world is this small and constantly rotating circle of what is relevant at the time. It's like the bright yellow Volkswagen. You don't notice it when you buy one, and they're everywhere. And I'm not the only one. I'm not the exception, I'm the norm. Little cells, little pockets of existence constantly changing and shifting focus to only what is relevant to them at the time. Where's the unity of man? Where's the humanity? You know, I was reading in some magazine about how they've been researching into cave paintings done by indigenous tribes such as the Aboriginals and other similar tribes that have lived all over the planet thousands of years ago, and they believe that these paintings depict how these people were able to travel between this realm of existence and others. And they have theorized that this is something we're all able to do, but somehow we've forgotten how to do it. That's a big fucking thing to forget how to do.
This is Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. Does anybody read? This is Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. Does anybody read? This is Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. This is an emergency. Please pick up. Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. This is an emergency. Please pick up. This is Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. Does anyone read? This is Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. This is an emergency. Please pick up. This is Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. This is an emergency. My father's gone missing about a kilometre from the station down the Robinson's track. The car's broken down and there is no sight of him or any sign of him there. I'm going to head over to Brad Thompson's place to try and get help, and if you pick up this message, please, I need assistance.
Scout? Where are you going, Princess? Where are you going with your trolley this time or not? Pretty dark out, aren't you scared?
How about we have a 2 a.m. carpet picnic? I can make some chamomile tea and we can have some toast with honey. Would you like that, Dad?
I miss you, Mum. I'm a bit scared.
Thank you. out Taylor at the Taylor station. This is an emergency. My father's gone missing about a kilometre from the station down the Robinson's track. The car's broken down and there is no sign of him or any sign of him there. I'm going to head over to Brad Thompson.
Thank you.
Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. Does anybody read? This is Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. Does anybody read? This is Scout Taylor at the Taylor Station. This is an emergency. Please pick up. Dad? 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 Why don't you tell me you're going out this morning? I've been looking for you all day. I saw the car out the track and you weren't around and I didn't know what to think. I saw the car out on the track and you went around it and I didn't know what to think. What have I got to do?
I just put 30 drops into the water and I just stir it around and then you take it and then you go to sleep and you don't wake up and that's it, isn't it, Dad? That's it, Dad. That's all I have to do. I just put the liquid and I put it in the water and then you drink it and then you go to sleep and then you're at peace and... I don't know if I can... What if something goes wrong? I just want you to be able to go to sleep and go and be okay and just be okay and be...
Mason, you there? Scout. Mason. Everything all right?
He said 30 drops were enough to kill a Mallee bull. Didn't seem to be working. What does that mean? Was he fighting to live? I just wanted him to be happy.